Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Automotive here. Today we are talking about common problems and reliability issues with Nissan's VQ35DE engine. The VQ35DE is a naturally aspirated 3.5 liter V6 that has been in production since 2000 and is still being made by Nissan today. The VQ35DE was initially made popular by the Nissan 350Z and the Infiniti G35 that it was used in back in the early 2000s. With these platforms, the VQ35 built a solid reputation for being extremely reliable and also being able to produce pretty good power with the forged crank and forged rods that it came with from the factory. So all in all, we had a powerful engine that had good power capacity and was extremely reliable, which is part of what created such a great reputation for the VQ35 that even still lives on today. These engines are known to keep kicking even past 250,000 miles with just basic regular maintenance. So that makes you question, what else do we have to talk about here today? Unfortunately, there are always things to talk about with engines when it comes to problems, issues, and things to be aware of if you're going to own one of these things. With that being said, we have just a few problems or known issues here that we want to talk about to help make you aware. There aren't a whole lot of things that I'm going to discuss here today that really cause any serious or significant problems that would lead to premature engine failure, so long as the engine's being properly maintained. So the first thing that we want to talk about here is high oil consumption. The VQ35s are known to consume or burn off a decent bit of oil, and that tends to get worse or more gradual over time as these engines age and get to higher mileage. Oil consumption isn't really a problem. It's just something to be aware of, that these engines do like to consume oil. So once you start getting to the higher mileage levels or onto an older engine, you're likely gonna have to start topping up on oil in between oil changes just to make sure you're not starving the engine of oil. Not a problem, but they do consume oil. And the second problem that we're gonna talk about is oil leaks. And so when you combine consuming oil with oil leaks, it does cause the possibility of running low on oil. And that, of course, is what then could lead to serious engine problems. First problem with these engines isn't really a problem. It's more so a heads up that you need to be aware of oil levels and make sure they don't get too low. And also just do frequent oil changes every 5,000 miles. Don't listen to the oil service life monitors on these things that let you go 8, 10+ thousand miles without doing an oil change. So that brings us to the second problem that I just mentioned, and that is oil leaks. The most common oil leak that you see on the VQ35 is with the valve cover gasket. The valve cover gasket creates a small oil leak, and then that allows oil to drip down kind of the sides of the engines, which again, isn't a problem. Usually the leak starts off small, it'll gradually get bigger over time, but it doesn't lead to a whole lot of performance issues or other engine issues. It just causes you to leak oil. And so you either need to keep topping up on it and make sure you don't run too low, but it's also a good idea to go ahead and get the valve cover gasket replaced, since ultimately gaskets are very cheap and the labor isn't too bad to get this done either. Overall, not a terrible problem, but again, like I mentioned, when you combine oil leaks with oil consumption, you just really need to make sure that you're staying topped up on oil. And then this brings us to our third problem, which is the only kind of real problem on this list. Yes, the valve cover gasket going bad is a problem, but that also tends to only happen once we start talking about getting to probably the 150,000 mile mark. So the third thing on our list, and the only thing here that could cause some serious problems, is timing chain failure. The timing chain itself doesn't tend to fail on the VQ35. It more so tends to be the tensioners and the guides. And those tensioners and guides can break, fail, or wear down over time, which basically is going to give you a timing chain rattle or a timing chain kind of clunking noise that you'll actually be able to hear when your engine's turned on. That's letting you know that the guides and the tensioners have worn out and that you are close to running into some more serious timing related issues. The good news with the timing chain problems on the VQ35 is you always get that rattling noise that comes with it. And so it is easy to identify ahead of time before it becomes a serious problem. If you wait too long with the timing chain rattle, it's possible the timing chain can jump teeth, it can completely fall off, and ultimately, that's when we start getting into timing chain problems causing serious, potentially catastrophic engine damage if you run into the timing chain completely breaking loose, falling off, or jumping too many gears and causing the valves and the pistons to collide because timing gets thrown so far off. So it is important to note that this can be problematic. The good news is it doesn't tend to happen just immediately. You usually are gonna get a timing chain rattle that's gonna go ahead and warn you, hey, we need to go ahead and look into the timing chain and make sure we replace it and replace all the components with it that tend to go bad. And again, the timing chains on these things tend to be pretty strong, but like I mentioned, these engines last a really long time, and so there are a lot of them out there on the roads that are high mileage. And typically, once you get to about the 150,000 mile mark, that's when it's good to go ahead and inspect and service the timing chain. And that's also about around the time when you'll start to experience some timing chain rattle, although it is possible, and in some cases, you'll start to experience it a little above the 100,000 mile mark as well. Again, this is another problem that really only tends to affect the older VQ35s, but also to some degree, a little bit of a maintenance item and something that we can prevent from causing any serious problems. And that's really all I have to talk about the VQ35. We've got a few, you know, oil consumption and oil leak issues, which is natural with older engines as they get to higher mileages. And then we have timing chain issues, which a timing chain is also something that does require a little bit of maintenance from time to time. And so there's nothing out of the ordinary having to inspect that or do a few replacements once we start talking about getting to the 150,000 mile mark. But with all that being said, the VQ35 can very easily go beyond 250,000 miles with just basic maintenance. These are extremely reliable engines, and they're actually pretty good from a tuning or tuner standpoint as well. You can add a little bit of power to them in naturally aspirated form, and just adding basic bolt-on mods really doesn't impact the reliability of these engines too much, and they do handle boost decently well. However, once we start talking about adding boost is when, of course, there is a trade-off or a sacrifice to reliability, but these engines, even in modified form, tend to be very reliable and great engines, which is what has given them such a great reputation over the years and is part of the reason that Nissan is still making this engine 25 years later. All right, guys, that wraps it up on our video for the VQ35. If you guys appreciate this content, please click the like button and subscribe to our channel, as we'll be doing a ton more videos on Nissan engines, as well as things like the 350Z, the 370, and so on and so forth.